Hi all, Sammy here with CNC Router Parts. Today we are zeroing in on zeroing with our Auto Z and Corner Finder touch plate. This is a tool that allows for quick and precise settings of your tool height and workpiece corner edge location. It is dual-sided for Z only or XYZ finding. It has a spring-loaded brass plate safety feature, quick connecting magnet, and corner finding wall. First of all, let's review zeroing. When opening Mach, we should ref all home to ensure our gantries and each of our axes are aligned to establish a relatable fixed relationship between the machine coordinates and the table. If our G54 work offsets are zero, then the machine origin shown in red and the G54 work coordinates shown in green would be the same. In most programs, this would be the front and leftmost extremes of the machine work envelope, though it is not the most convenient location for most material setup. Instead, we want to have offset values that move the program origin so we can locate our project in a more convenient location. Stick around till the end and I'll show you how to install the HTML script in Mach 3. Now that we have a grasp on what zeroing is, we need to determine which Z-axis surface we will be using. We can zero off the material surface or the machine bed by placing the flat side of the touch plate down. We must be sure that our machine setup and our file setup align. You can reference off of any corner of the material for your X and Y, though it is common to use the front left corner of the material. Again, it is very important to make sure that our file setup is correct in relation to the machine setup. Stay to the end for a review on how to set up your zeroing point in your VCarve file. Let's talk about how the Auto Z and Corner Finding touch plate works and see it in action. For finding X, Y, and Z, place the touch plate with the corner finding edge on the origin corner of the material, then drive the spindle with the router bit centered about an inch above the brass plate. We'll attach the magnet to the collet or bit. In Mach, we can now click Auto Tool Zero, which will open a dialog box. You can select which axes you like to zero. I'll do X, Y, and Z. Enter in the diameter of the bit and select which corner you are zeroing off of. I'll use the left front. I also like to opt for pausing between axes so that we can make sure our flutes are properly aligned. Click OK. The bit will lower down and contact the brass plate. This will complete the circuit and allow the program to calculate the distance the bit is from the material surface. A dialog box will prompt us to align the widest edge of the flute to hit the X wall. And again, Mach will have us rotate the bit 90 degrees to contact the Y wall. Now let's talk a little bit about router bit selection in relation to the touch plate. Starting with an end mill, you can zero X, Y, and Z, though we should be conscious of the location of the flutes in regards to the walls of the touch plate. Our goal is for the widest point, or the cutting edge of the flute, to contact the X and Y walls. Alternatively, you can use the metal dowel to find X and Y. This will give us an accurate reading of the XY home, though you will have to zero the Z-axis when you switch in your router bit. Now there are a few router bits that we can only use the Z-axis side of the touch plate. Due to the angle and profile of a V-bit, we can't get the reading of X and Y, though you can use the Z-axis only side of the touch plate. Let's switch out our down spiral for a V-bit. If there is any variation in the height of your material, we can zero to the specific spot where that portion of your design is located. Also, we can slide the touch plate to the spindle rather than having to drive the spindle to the touch plate. Once again, click Auto Tool Zero, this time only selecting the Z-axis, and press OK. The diameter of the bit isn't relevant in this operation. Let's talk a little bit about the design of the touch plate. At first, it may seem counterintuitive that the router bit contacts the inner walls when the corner is closer to the outer edges, though you can see it stays snug on the corner, and if the bit were to contact the exterior walls, it could knock the touch plate off the material. The HTML script that we copy into the editor in Mach will determine all of the measurements of the touch plate and will also take into account the diameter of the router bit. That's the basics on our Auto Z and corner finding touch plate. Stick around for a walkthrough on setting up your zero in your Vectric file and how to install the HTML script in Mach 3. Thanks y'all for joining me. I'll walk us through a review on how to set up your zeroing point in your Vectric file. Open a new file, enter your material dimensions. First, select your Z-axis reference, the material surface or the machine bed. Then select your XY datum position. Any of the four corners will work. If selected, uncheck Use Offset. Then click OK to open your file. Any toolpaths you generate will use this corner as an origin point. We must configure Mach in order to use the touch plate. In the description below, you will find a link to our website. Navigate to Pro CNC Accessories and locate the Auto Z and corner finding touch plate image. Scroll to the bottom and find the instructions. On this page, you will find written instructions on how to use the touch plate. There's a lot to take in on this page, but since we have a plug-and-play controller, a pre-configured machine XML file, really all we need is the script itself. I'll scroll down to the code window, select all the code, and Ctrl-C to copy it. Now I'll switch back to Mach 3, go to Operator, and Edit Button Script in the toolbar. Click on the Auto Z Zero button. In the code box, I'll replace the not implemented message with the code I copied from the instructions page using Ctrl-P for paste. Exit and save the script. Restart Mach and it should be ready to run. For your first time, keep your hand near the e-stop just in case the script wasn't implemented. The spring-loaded brass plate will give us a moment to react. Hit stop and then make any adjustments necessary.